Now in this video, I'm making a hand wheel for my Scout lathe. And on the first upload, some people noticed that I forgot the knockout bar hole in my hand wheel. Well, this is the completed hand wheel. Anyway, oops, I forgot to put the hole in here for the knockout bar. So let me make that little clip and I'll put it in the video in the appropriate place. So I'm sure some of you had a really good laugh with this, and maybe this will be the video that goes viral. I don't know. Let me show you how I made that hole. Now I am standing at my Scout lathe, and I've got a simple project I want to do for this machine. I'm going to put a hand wheel on the outboard side of the spindle. And what comes with this lathe, as all the robust lathes, are two face plates. Now this face plate can be simply used as a hand wheel, but I'm going to attach a piece of wood to this and make it a little bit fancier. All right, now I have selected a very nice piece of cherry for my hand wheel. It's probably right at 2 inches thick, which will be nice. That'll allow me a little bit of dimension for profiling. Now, here is the faceplate, okay? And I've got a circle drawn on this block of wood where the faceplate will go. And I've also got some double stick tape, double-sided double stick tape on there. I'm going to line this up. It's not extremely critical. We're not making a china cabinet, as they say. All right, so there we go. And I can take this over on my bandsaw and safely cut that round later on. Now, the next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to drill holes. I'm going to pre-drill the holes with a Vix bit, okay? Now, these are self-centering bits. If I can get them to stay on there. Hello? Okay, here's a really big one. And that's probably a 1/4-inch drill in there. That's way too big, you know, it's like Goldilocks. This one may be too small. That's probably 1/8 of an inch. I'm gonna go for this one right here. So turn the block back over, get my drill set up, and I'm gonna do all this with my handheld drill. Get that in there, and maybe you can see a little bit better. There's a drill bit right in the center of that, and these are really designed for applying hinges to a door or something, and they're really, really cool. So I'm gonna just go around. All right, now what I've done is I've pre-drilled these holes. They're a pilot hole. Okay, in woodworking terminology. Let me go find some screws that will be appropriate for this. All right, now I have selected what I think is a really good option for a screw. These are called a Power Pro 1 multi-material. It's an exterior screw. And here's one of them. They're 1¾ inches. And I've got to be careful on the opposite side of this not to take off too much wood. Now, I'm going to do one more step in here. I'm going to take a tapered drill bit, and I'm going to go through here and just drill these a little bit farther down. So I've got a good center on each one of these. Now, according to the package, there is no need for pre-drilling. In the spirit of being obsessive compulsive, I got them pre-drilled. So anyway, let me just quickly put these screws in there. I think once these are in there, that hand wheel is not going anyplace. And we sure don't want it to. Let me just line my screws up in these holes. Yeah, this is going to be very secure. And I believe I got these screws at Home Depot. All right, now I've had this lathe for quite a while. I should have done this some time ago, but this will be a nice addition. All right, now whether you are new to wood churning or not, there are some lessons in this little project. There's my faceplate securely fastened to my block of cherry. That's going to be pretty. So I'm going to thread this onto my spindle. Lock the headstock down and make sure it's tight on there. So I've drawn a circle on here, and that corresponds to the opposite side where I have drilled the screws in. All right, so I've got to avoid that a little bit, and I'm going to just do something here. I don't know. Turn this on a little bit. And so I think from there to there, I'm going to avoid that. I can probably go down probably a half an inch and I won't hit those screws. So let's start turning. There are some basic things we need to keep in mind here. This is a cross grain turning. All right, grain's running this way. So to do a proper cut, I've got to cut in this direction across the grain. And the first thing I'm going to do is true up the outside of this. Certainly do a little bit of profiling on the outside of this circumference of this hand wheel. I want to make it comfortable, so I'm thinking just one big bead in here would be really, really nice. I think I'm going to start on the back side and just start with that bead. I'll do a draw cut around here, and I'm trying to stay out of the line of fire. Now I'm turning about 1400 RPM. Now I'm going to come around the front side, do the same thing. Now let's just see. It's not too bad right there, but I'm going to do a little bit more profiling as we go along. I'm going to come out here to the center. I've got an idea of what shape I want to do on this, and I'm thinking I'm going to get a smaller tool to do that. All right, now I have selected a smaller spindle gouge, and I'm going to make a cove right here and also in the center. Okay, now I darkened that line that I made originally on there, and that's where my screw is, or the screws. So I got a little bit of a profile on there, and that really feels pretty good with my thumb in there. And I'm thinking I need to make one on the other side just a little bit as well, which I think I will do. So I'm going to take a scraper and just kind of clean this up. And I didn't want to make this an all-day project. This will work really well. My Boxmaster scraper. Okay, I like it. I'm going to do a little sanding on this. I'm going to put this same profile on the back just so I have kind of a better grip on that. I can see that that will be beneficial. All right, now I've gone through up to about 400 grit on this. I don't think it needs to be real smooth necessarily. I'm going to go grab some of my oil finish, and I'm gonna put a coat on there. I can always just kind of keep adding more finish to this, or maybe some wax. All right, now here's my knockout bar, and it's exactly 3/8 of an inch in diameter. But just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna put a hole in here that's a little bit bigger than the 3/8. I've got a 1/2 inch drill bit here that I'm going to use to make this hole. And my face plate is plenty big, so I'm not going to run into my Morse taper. This just fits into my tailstock Morse taper. We'll put this hand wheel back on here and we will make quick work of drilling this hole. Boy. All right, let's see what else I forgot. All right. Make sure everything is locked down securely. I'll just test this with my knockout bar, make sure I'm getting through there. All right, there we go. Okay. Okay, there we go. All right, now I've got my hand wheel back in place, and I'm going to make sure that I have those set screws tightened down very securely. All right, back to the video. All right, now when I'm finishing something, I tend to go in kind of a certain pattern for a while. This particular finish I'm going to use right here, this is a Sam Maloof finish. It's step one, and it's got boiled linseed oil, raw tung oil, urethane varnish, and mineral spirits in equal parts. Okay. We'll put a little bit of this on, and that should be a good finish. And I can always add wax or something on top of that. I'm going to turn my lathe on a little slow. We'll apply some of this. Yeah. Nice little project for a Saturday morning. Something I should have done a long time ago. Now, something to keep in mind, when you put this hand wheel on the outboard side of the spindle, it will be turned 180 degrees, so the profile may not match up to what you're turning right now, or what I'm turning right now. So I kind of thought about this, but it's not really a big deal. Here we go. Take this off, and I'll show you what I did on the back side. I've got another little groove right here, and this will be sort of a, you know, thumb and finger kind of situation. I don't think that's ever going to come off, because this may be turning at 3,000 RPM, and we need to have that secure. I didn't think I needed a real large diameter on this. All right, let me put it in my spindle on the opposite side of my lathe. Here's my faceplate. Now, on this particular lathe, the inboard spindle out here and the outboard spindle both have right-hand threads. And for this lathe, you can get an attachment. It's an outboard attachment that will turn 21 inches, which isn't too bad for a little lathe like this. All right, very good. Now let's just see if it works. All right, now when I made this, I wanted to make sure I didn't have any sharp edges or anything that would catch a sleeve or anything on that. And I think I did a pretty good job. Okay, from here, well, it's going to take me longer to edit this video than it did to make this little hand wheel. That was a good project. That was fun, simple, and I hope that inspires you to kind of do an upgrade on your lathe, whatever it may be. And maybe it's not a hand wheel. Maybe it's something else. Anyway, thank you very much for tuning in. I like it. Please subscribe and share my videos. It means a lot to me. It helps me. When you promote my videos, it inspires me to do more. So I will talk to you next time. Thank you very much.